Now, this time, we're going to fix sausage omelet. Sausage and onion omelet. I wanted to show you how to do an omelet. One thing I think is the hardest thing for us is to flip the omelet over, because that's all we have to do. We don't have to turn the whole thing like we have to do with the fried egg, but we have to flip it over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to brown some sausage and a few onions. Just brown them, set it to the side, and then I'm going to show you how to make a sausage, cheese, and onion omelet, okay? I get so tickled about my mom because she showed me all these tricks of the trade, you know, how to make an omelet nice and fluffy, don't cook it too much, and make it hard, and it really makes it difficult when you go into a restaurant because I find myself saying, can I have it medium? Please don't overcook it, and it makes it really good. It's all about choice, because some of you, you want them eggs hard, and there's no way around it. I'm not mad at you. I want you to learn what we call in the food industry the proper way, and then you can tweak it to your way. So we're going to let the sausage and onion brown, and then we're going to whip our eggs and put it in a separate skillet, of course. And I'm going to show you how to construct an omelet. It's real fast, okay? What I'm doing now is just taking my fork and breaking up the sausage. Sometimes you have to add a little substance to get the onions caramelized and the sauce stew. I'm going to show you a trick that I do, okay? That works out real well. I try to lessen the fat content because you know it's enough with the sausage. So what I'll do is lower the heat for one, add a little water. See what that does? Now you want to get your onions to soften up because you don't want them crispy. And then it's going to go ahead and cook your sausage, but it's not going to stick to the pan. One thing you have to realize, and I'm talking to beginners, people, okay, I'm all about teaching parents how to cook for their kids. So if you know all this, just hold on, I'll get to you. But I'm talking to the parents. When you cut your stove off, it's still cooking. Stove is off. You see what I mean? Utilize that heat. Utilize that heat. It's still cooking. Your sausage is done. To me, I want my onions a little done, a little more done. So I'm going to utilize that heat. So while I'm getting my eggs and my cheese together, I'm going to let the sausage cook with the stove off. Everything's nice and done and ready. See that? So we're going to set it to the side. We're going to cut the stove back on. Okay. Now, we got the skillet. Another thing I wanted to share with you is spatula. I have a spatula, as you see, there's no holes in this one, okay, which is very nice. I'm going to make sure I get in the camera. But see how thin it is? Okay. Then you have the spatula with the holes in it. I think if you're picking up something that needs to drain through, this will be really good for that. And then you have the metal spatula. Now, this is what gets me, and this is my favorite, the metal one. You see how thin that is? Let me see if I can move my hands out the way. See how thin that is? Now compared to that, see how thin that is? See? Real paper thin, and this is not bad, but to me, you can get everything out of the skillet with this one. But it does scratch the skillets when you have Teflon. As you see, this used to be sort of a Teflon. It's not now, but it sure cooks well. And this, really, I think they built the plastic ones mainly for the nonstick. So if you got nonstick, I will go for the plastic. So, that's my take on that. Okay, it's heating up. So, once again, crack the eggs together. Okay, crack them together. This is going to be a 3-egg omelet. Your last egg, crack on the stove, no problem. Once again, be very careful not to get any shells. Look for shells before you start beating. Make sure you don't have any in there. Okay? This is something from the egg, so I guess that's okay. And as far as the embryo and all that, people take that out. I don't. I think an egg is an egg, and I'm eating it. I like eggs. I don't have any issues with that. It's up to you. If you see the embryo in there and you want to take it out, take it out. I don't. I just look for the eggs. I want all the nutrition I can get, and that's what I do. So we got them whipped up really well. You want your skillet sort of hot. Like I said, it don't have to be super hot. One thing, when I do these scrambled eggs, I don't care if it gets super hot, because that's the quicker the eggs to scramble. But with your omelet, I don't think it should be super hot, because you can't move your egg that much. Okay, so now we're going to put the butter in the skillet. We can move it around a little bit, okay? We want to get that butter melted as soon as we can. All around. Make sure you coat the edges of your skillet really well. That's going to come to help you later on. Okay, we take the whipped eggs and we just pour them in there. Just like this. Pour them in. Okay. Try to make sure as even as possible. Okay. All around, even as possible. And what you want to do, you notice around the edges where it's cooking, see that? You want it to settle. You want to kind of make a thick piece of egg. So all around the edges, it's just settling. You don't bother it right away. You're going to flip one side, and one side you're going to keep that way. So as it cooks, now I have the heat on medium, I should tell you that too. So you see how it's starting to bubble? What you're going to do is move your egg a little bit. See that? More raw egg is pouring there. That's how you build your base for your omelet. See that? And you let that cook. You want to make sure. See what I did? I just moved it a little bit. Not much. Just enough for that raw egg to get everywhere it needs to go. That's how you build your base for your omelet. You allow that raw egg to run around and to settle. And it's going to cook as well. And that's how you build the thickness for your omelet. Because it has to be thick enough to flip. Okay? And you do it again. You just move it. Just a little bit. As it cooks more, you move it less. Because you're not going to have much eggs left to do it. So you just go around. Now when you're buying your skillets, you guys, if you have the money to get nonstick, I don't have a problem with that. But if you don't, most skillets, the economical ones, are nonstick. After a while, it's going to rub off, but just keep them clean and do the best you can. All else fails, keep a can of canola spray around. That always helps. That'll make any pan nonstick. But I'm big on flavoring my food with whatever. Okay, so now as you see here? Most of the egg is formed and cooked, because you don't want to overcook it. So you take your meat, just one side, and then you got your cheese on one side. There you go. Okay. Fun part. Ready? Okay. Now you build your base, all you do, flip. That's it. You flip. It's done. Now, remember, cut your stove off. Still cooking. There you go. I take it off the stove because I don't want to cook anymore. You, if you want to cook a little more to be a little more done, you can leave it on the stove, even with it off, and it'll finish cooking out. Me, personally, I don't like my eggs too well done, so I stopped it. Now, I'm going to show you. See how it looks? Now watch this. That's it. Slid it right off. See? Look at that. Perfect omelet. That's all I wanted to show you. I'm getting ready to eat.